I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making fried chicken cutlets, and this is going to be on our Mother's Day table. We just made some sriracha dipping sauce, and that's what we're going to use to dip the chicken into. So let me show you how to prepare it. Here I have 5 pounds of chicken breasts. They're boneless, skinless chicken breasts. You can see some fat on them, but I will trim that off. I want them to be flattened so that they're cutlets. And you can see, I'll have to touch this, any one of them is fairly large. And I think the easiest thing for me to do is to cut that in half. And if you have kitchen scissors or shears, you could just do that. And it doesn't matter what shape it comes out in, but just try to make them fairly equally sized. Then I want to trim off any fat like that. I never leave that. Some people like to have that along with their cooking oil because it is a fat that can be used for cooking, but now that's really clean looking. If you don't like that little bit of gristle that runs through the chicken breast, you may cut that off. I don't usually. Then what we're going to do is come over here and cover this with plastic. And that is to prevent it from splattering everywhere as I pound it. Now, I have my contaminated hand right here. I'm going to wash my hands before I show you the pounding of the chicken breast. I have my half chicken breast, or half of a half, actually, under plastic. I do want to say that I washed all of these or rinsed them off just because they may have picked up some bacteria or something at the store. But they were very fresh when they were bought, and so they should be good to go. So you just start pounding and try to have a protective shield like the plastic so you don't get it all over yourself. You will see it start to flatten. Just try to keep it even. When this gets to be about 1/2 inch and you see that the size of it has about doubled, that's probably about when you want to stop. So I'm going to take this one piece and show you what I would do to treat it, and then I'll finish up the rest. I have a platter sitting here, and I have some salt that I have put in a container that will only be used for this purpose, so it will not be contaminating something else. But I do want to salt them, and I like to use just regular salt that I have in my kitchen, and then I'm going to grind this pepper on. And when I come back, I'll have all of these ready and heaped up on that platter. So we have the chicken breast tenderized and salted and peppered, so you can see that these are now fairly flat and even, and they will fry evenly. I am going to coat them, and I want to show you what I have here for coating. In this first flat dish, which happens to be a Pyrex pie dish for me, I've got 3/4 cup of flour. Doesn't matter if it's self-rising or all-purpose. I have 3/4 cup of cornstarch. So I'm just going to put those together. And you may use all cornstarch or all flour if you like. And that's good enough. It doesn't have to be perfect. Right here, I put 3 eggs in and whisk them. Then I added about 3 ounces of water. So that's our egg wash. And then here I have 2 cups of panko breadcrumbs. So let's do one. Take the chicken with tongs, if you don't want to do this by hand, and make sure that it gets some flour and corn starch on it on both sides. That makes the egg wash stick to it in the next container. So you can see what it looks like. Shake it so any excess will fall off, and it'd be nice if I remove these utensils. Lay this down and then turn it over. And then go on to the panko breadcrumbs. Again, let it drain off a little bit and then place it in here. Stretch it out and turn. Just get a single layer on it. Or you may put more if you like it really crusty. And that one is ready to go in the skillet. Well, the skillet hasn't been prepared yet, so let me show you how to prepare that, and I'll be finishing this up while the oil is heating. I have a 14-inch iron skillet. You do not have to use an iron skillet, but it needs to be a fairly large skillet, and I'm going to have to do probably more than one frying because that turned out to be quite a bit of area once those were pounded. So I'm going to put peanut oil in, and I'll show you how much to put in. It doesn't matter the size of your skillet, but you want to cover the bottom and come up the sides just a little bit. And that amount that it comes up the side should kind of bubble as it fries and get the bottom half fried easily. Then you will turn them and fry the top half. So all of this can be done right here on the stovetop. It does not have to go to the oven. So I'm turning this to medium level of heat. And I'm going to turn my back on it, but I'll have to keep an eye out for it coming to a point where it is hot enough to fry the chicken. Now, we don't want it to smoke, so if it smokes, I will throw it away and start again. So we have our chicken breast seasoned and coated and ready to fry. And I want to show you what was left over. This looks like almost half of the flour and cornstarch mixtures, and I used 3/4 cup of each. You could cut that down to 1/2 cup of each if you want to, if you do the same coverage that I did here. And probably instead of 3 eggs, you could get by with 2 eggs. Now over here, I ran out. So I put an extra cup of panko breadcrumbs in, and there's this much left. So at least 2.5 cups were necessary for the chicken that I had. Now that it's ready, I have been heating my oil for the last few minutes, and I want to check and see what the level of the temperature is. This little gun can be used to point right at the oil, and I don't know if you can read that, but it says 356. 350 is what I'm shooting for, so I think we're ready to put some of these in, and you want them in one layer. You don't want to double them up. Just refry if necessary. Go through 2 or 3 iterations of this process, but they do stretch out and take a lot of room. Try to make use of the edge and just bring them over with tongs or whatever you're comfortable with and place them side by side. And we'll cover the bottom and then we'll let them cook until the bottom looks done, looks brown, and then we'll turn them over and cook until done. They will come off onto this double layer of paper toweling after that. These look like they're ready to be turned, and I do want to tell you that after you put all 5 pieces or whatever you have into your skillet, the oil will cool down quite a lot, so you'll have to turn your heat up. You may have to turn it up to high for just a little bit and then turn it back down. But you can tell by looking at the bottom of these that they're nice and crispy and brown, and they're ready to be turned. So we have them all just about turned, and we'll wait for that other side to cook and look the same. The chicken cutlets have fried about an equal time on this other side, and they are obviously done. So I'm going to bring them out and drain them on paper toweling. I did turn the skillet off, the gas off, so that this wouldn't flare up and get really hot without any chicken in there, but I'll have to turn it back on for my next bunch. So here we have our fried chicken cutlets for Mother's Day, and we're serving it with Sriracha Dipping Sauce. And I want to take a taste. I'm not going to take very much because this is actually going to the table. I'll just come over here. I have a meat fork and I have just a steak knife here that allows me to cut through and let you see what the inside looks like. Doesn't that look delicious? So this comes over to my plate, and you notice I've got thyme here and also over here decorating the platter. We had fresh thyme in our herb garden because it had lived all through the horrid winter season. So let's see what this tastes like. I'm going to take my fork and just make a little cut right here. It looks really good. And I'm going to give myself some of the sriracha dipping sauce. dipping sauce. We'll just spoon that onto the dish and dip. Mmm, that crust tastes good. And I didn't get too much of the sauce. It's rather spicy. I've already tested the sauce for you on that video, so I'm going to take just the chicken. I think the thing you'll notice most is the crunchiness of the crust. And also, you know that these were drained on paper towel, so that means that a lot of the greasiness got drained off of it. So these are rather dry, but the meat is nice and juicy because it's sealed in with that crust. But you don't feel guilty like you're eating a lot of grease, but it is fried chicken. It's really good. Hope you enjoy it for Mother's Day or for any time.